وبركاته. ما شاء الله تبارك الله ما شاء الله طيب.
So it's very quiet here. Let's make some noise. Halal noise. I just want to see who's in the house, like I did last year. I want to see who's in the house and then make it kind of not entertaining, but I just want to see. You know what I'm trying to do? I want to know where my people are. Are the Moroccans in town today? Are the Moroccans in the house? فكاين مغاربة الحمد لله اللهم لك الحمد طيب. The others will be upset. Are the Somalis in the house tonight? Scotland. الحمد لله. How about Pakistan? And of course, when we say Pakistan, that includes India and Bangladesh. That's all Pakistan. Is Norway in town today? Allahu Akbar. May Allah bless you all. Zakum Allah khair. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless you. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant all of you Jannat al-Firdaus. Just a few days ago, I was looking at online, I was looking at some videos about the peace conference. And I was looking at the very first time when I gave a lecture here. And I knew that that video was very old. The only way I knew that that video was really old is because my hair was still black. That was like 6 years ago, Sheikh, a long time ago. And now it's, mashallah, it's all gray. Allahumma lak alhamd. Shayyabat nihud. And my sisters and my brothers, your story and my story is really short. It was just like yesterday, we say. It was just like yesterday. قصتي وقصتكم قصيرة. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions this story beautifully in Surah Al-Mu'minun. So if I can get your attention, inshallah ta'ala, because I have a very, very important message that I'd like to share with you. This message starts from Surah Al-Mu'minun, verse number 10 onwards. Just to explain how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how He describes our story, your story and my story. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, بَعْدَ أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ مِنْ سُلَالَةٍ مِنْ طِينٍ ثُمَّ جَعَلْنَاهُ نُطْفَةً فِي قَرَارٍ مَكِينٍ ثُمَّ خَلَقْنَا النُّطْفَةَ عَلَقَةً فَخَلَقْنَا الْعَلَقَةَ مُضْغَةً فَخَلَقْنَا الْمُضْغَةَ عِظَامًا فَكَسَوْنَا الْعِظَامَ لَحْمًا ثم أنشأناه خلقا آخر فتبارك الله أحسن الخالقين ثم إنكم بعد ذلك لميتون ثم إنكم يوم القيامة تبعثون. That's our story. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and we have created man from clay. From this, in fact, it started from this liquid, a discharge, which turned into cloth, which turned into a limb, which turned into flesh. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and then we clotted the flesh turned into bones, and then we clotted the bone with skin. And then we made it into a human being. فَتَبَارَكَ اللَّهُ أَحْسَنُ خَالِقِينَ. Very few stages. And then right after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ثُمَّ إِنَّكُمْ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ لَمَيِّتُونَ. And then right after that, what will happen? You shall die. Clay, discharge, نُطْفَ مُضْغَ عَلَقَ عِظَام لَحْم إِنسَان ثُمَّ الْمَوْت. And then death. And then you shall die. And right after that, what will happen? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and then you shall be resurrected. Look at the stages. Very short. From clay to death to resurrection. And then what will happen after that, my brothers and sisters? People will be split into teams, two groups. Fariqan. Fariqun fil jannah وفريق في السعير. Two teams, one group in Jannah and one group in Hellfire, العياذ بالله. After death, that's what will happen.
ونفخ في الصور فصعق من في السماوات ومن في الأرض إلا من شاء الله.
Today, it will be all about Quran. Please pay attention. The only thing I will be talking with you today is Quran. قال الله وقال رسول الله.
ونفخ في الصور.
And then the trumpet will be blown onto. And then people will sway.
ونفخ في الصور.
And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the fact in Surah Al-Zumar how people will die and how people will be resurrected and how they will go, the teams, the team that will go to hellfire and the team that will be dragged to hellfire and the team that will be taken to Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, with regard to the other team, I'm going to start with the other team. I'm going to start with the other group. I'm going to start with the people of the left. Because like I said, there's only two groups. There's only two teams. Fariqan. Fariqun fil jannah wa fariqun fil sa'ir. Ahlu al jannah wa ahlu al nar. Ahlu al yameen wa ahlu al shimal. That's it. That's all there is. The people of the left and the people of the right. The people of jannah and the people of hellfire. I'm going to start to talk about those other people, which is not you, inshallah ta'ala. The people of the left. We need to talk about them, you know, briefly. There is no, in fact, we do need to talk about the things that lead to hellfire, iyadu billah. Quickly. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, in Surah Al-Zumar,
بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وسيق الذين كفروا إلى جهنم زمرا وسيق الذين كفروا إلى جهنم زمرا حتى إذا جاءوها فتحت أبوابها وقال لهم خزنتها ألم يأتكم رسل منكم يتلون عليكم آيات ربكم وينذرونكم لقاء يومكم هذا قالوا بلى ولكن حقت كلمة العذاب على الكافرين قيل ادخلوا أبواب جهنم خالدين فيها فبئس مثوى المتكبرين.
And the people of hellfire will be dragged to hellfire زمرا, in groups. They will be taken in groups. Imagine, as they are resurrected from the graves, naked, barefooted, but nobody will care about nobody else that day. Everybody will be saying, including the prophets and the messengers, nafsi, nafsi. Everybody will be saying, myself, myself. يَوْمَ تَذْهَلُ كُلُّ مُرْضِعَةٍ عَمَّا أَرْضَعَتْ وَتَضَعُ كُلُّ ذَاتِ حَمْلٍ حَمْلَهَا وَتَرَى النَّاسَ سُكَارَى وَمَا هُمْ بِسُكَارَى وَلَكِنَّ عَذَابَ اللَّهِ شَدِيدٌ. The day when a mom who's sucking her baby, she will drop her baby. Nobody will care about nobody else. So they are resurrected from their graves, naked, barefooted, terrified, petrified. As they reach now the gates of hellfire, as soon as they reach the gates of hellfire, فُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُهَا. The gates will open up. And then the gatekeeper of hellfire will say, أَلَمْ يَأْتِكُمْ رُسُلٌ مِّنْكُمْ يَتْلُونَ عَلَيْكُمْ آيَاتِ رَبِّكُمْ وَيُنذِرُنَّكُمْ لِقَاءَ يَوْمِكُمْ هَذَا. Haven't prophets been sent out to you to warn you about today? To let you about today, they would say, Bala, yes, they have. We've heard many lectures and many seminars we've attended and many conferences. People came to us and told us about today. They did tell us, and prophets and messengers, they did come to us. ولكن حقت كلمة العذاب على الكافرين. And what would they be told? Enter جهنم خالدين فيها. Enter hellfire خالدين فيها. Eternally, والعياذ بالله. Eternally. My brothers and sisters, imagine this. People in hellfire, in fact, before they enter hellfire, they will have wishes. Altogether, I'm going to count these wishes. 5 wishes. One before hellfire and one inside hellfire. Altogether.
This is Iman. She's 14 years old, a Norwegian Muslim living with her parents. In the next 20 seconds, she is going to send indecent pictures of herself to her secret boyfriend. This is why. Norway, a Scandinavian country that Muslims migrated to 50 years ago, with around 200,000 Muslims. But this is changing. Muslim names are increasing, but Iman is dying in the hearts of our youth. The vast majority of these Muslims do not pray and are leaving their Islamic heritage and adopting the Western lifestyle. Why is this happening? Why are the youth leaving the Islamic way of life? The majority of Muslims came to Norway seeking financial opportunities. The mosques that were established were centered around culture from back home, and the next generation of Muslims assimilated to the Western lifestyle. The main source of Islamic knowledge remained the Friday sermon that was conducted in the mother tongue of the first generation of Muslims, so the youth didn't connect to it. Iman is not happy at home. Her parents often tell her to start praying and stay away from boys, and that makes Iman feel suffocated and depressed, because no one taught her why Islam teaches Muslims to pray, or why it sets moral boundaries for relationships with the opposite gender. Iman doesn't know what to do. On one side, she loves her family and she loves Allah. On the other side, she doesn't understand Islam and its restrictions and guidelines don't make sense to her. So she is living a double life. Muslim at home and someone else outside. Iman is not just an individual. She symbolizes the Iman of the majority of young Norwegian Muslims. They are struggling to retain their Islamic identity and are drifting away from Islam. We need to save Iman. We need to start at the grassroots level. The problem lies in the lack of Islamic knowledge, resulting in the weakening of Iman. So we want to build the country's first Islamic Dawah center, combined with a masjid that will share the message of Islam in a way that the youth of today can relate to. It will have a youth center where the youth can come instead of hanging in the streets or going to Western clubs. It will have Islamic programs and activities where the youth can learn their religion. It will have a studio for mass production of Dawah material for social media. It will educate the Muslim community on how to bring up their children on Islamic values. We have already raised about $1 million locally, and to make this project come true, we need to raise the remaining amount. There are 1.8 billion Muslims, but the question is, are you one of those very special people who will help save Iman? Please, click the link, give for the sake of Allah, and earn your reward. Also, we need to make the Muslim world aware of this campaign, so please do whatever you can. Share this video on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and all other social media networks. We alone cannot save Iman, but together, we can.
My brothers and sisters, imagine this. People in hellfire, in fact, before they enter hellfire, they will have wishes. Altogether, I'm going to count these wishes. Five wishes. One before hellfire and one inside hellfire. Altogether. Imagine. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Surah Al-An'am, verse number 27. وَلَوْ تَرَىٰ إِذْ وُقِفُوا عَلَى النَّارِ. They haven't entered hellfire yet. They're outside. وَقِفُوا. وَلَوْ تَرَىٰ إِذْ وُقِفُوا عَلَى النَّارِ فَيَقُولُوا يَا لَيْتَنَا نُرَدْ وَلَا نُكَذِّبَ بِآيَاتِ رَبِّنَا وَنَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. The very first thing, before they even enter hellfire, they reach the gates of hellfire and they look at hellfire. Now they're looking at it. وَقِفُوا عَلَى النَّارِ. They're standing by hellfire. They see hellfire. The first thing they will say, يَا لَيْتَنَا. We wish to be sent back. That's the first wish. We wish to be sent back. And we will not rebuke the message. We will not reject the message. And we will believe, they will say. And we would believe. This is the first wish. And they will be thrown in hellfire. Now they go in hellfire. May Allah save you from it. You know what they will say, the first wish? Rabbana
ربنا ارجعنا نعمل صالحا إنا موقنون.
صلاة السجدة.
ربنا أخرجنا منها فإن عدنا فإنا ظالمون. قال اخسأوا فيها ولا تكلمون.
صلاة المؤمنون. In Surah Sajda, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that they will say,
رَبَّنَا رَجِعْنَا نَعْمَلْ صَالِحَ إِنَّا مُقِنُونَ. Oh Allah, bring us back to work righteousness, to do righteousness. Bring us back. We promise we will pray. Bring us back. We promise we will believe. Bring us back. We promise
we will wear hijab.
We promise. رَجِعْنَا نَعْمَلْ صَالِحَ. رَبَّنَا رَجِعْنَا نَعْمَ الصَّالِحَ. Bring us back and we shall work righteousness. We shall be good. We promise we will be good. In this other ayah they will say, رَبَّنَا رَجِعْنَا رَبَّنَا خَرِجْنَا مِنْهَا فَإِنْ عُدْنَا فَإِنَّا ظَالِمُونَ. Oh Allah, bring us back out. If we come back to it, indeed we're wrongdoers. Indeed we're ظالمون.
قَالَ اَخْسَأُوا فِيهَا وَلَا تُكَلِّمُونَ. Stay in it forever and don't talk to me. So they will have another wish. Listen to these brothers and sisters. Interesting wish. They will say. And this wish will be addressed from the people of hellfire to the people of Jannah. The people they used to mock. The people they used to ridicule. The people they used to make fun of. They will tell them.
وَنَادَى أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ أَصْحَابَ الْجَنَّةِ وَنَادَى أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ أَصْحَابَ الْجَنَّةِ أَنْ أَفِيضُوا عَلَيْنَا مِنَ الْمَاءِ أَنْ أَفِيضُوا عَلَيْنَا مِنَ الْمَاءِ أَوْ مِمَّا رَزَقَكُمُ اللَّهِ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ حَرَّمَهُمَا عَلَى الْكَافِرِينَ.
The people of hellfire, they will address the people of Jannah and they will say, Afido, could you please imagine? They will say, could you please give us some water? Or something that Allah has blessed you with. All we want.
Why water? Ya akhwan, ya habibi, ya habibi. Everything in hellfire is from fire. Clothing from fire. Food from fire. Water from fire. Everything is from fire. That's why it's called al-jahannam. Fire. Al-sa'ir. So they will say, oh, please give us some water. أَفِيضُوا عَلَيْنَا مِنَ الْمَاءِ أَوْ مِمَّا رَزَقَكُمُ اللَّهِ or anything that Allah has blessed you with, they will be told, إِنَّ اللَّهَ حَرَّمَهُمَا عَلَى الْكَافِرِينَ.
They will be told, Allah has made it prohibited upon the non-believers. Even in water there, you won't be able to get. That's the second wish. Or the third. They have another wish. Fourth wish. Now this wish will be addressed to the gatekeepers of hellfire. In Surah Ghafir, they will say, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم
وقال أصحاب النار لخزنة جهنم وقال أصحاب النار لخزنة جهنم ادعوا ربكم يخفف عنا يوما من العذاب
بس يوم
ادعوا ربكم يخفف عنا يوما من العذاب قالوا أولم تك تأتيكم رسلكم بالبينات قالوا بلى قالوا فادعوا وما دعاء الكافرين إلا في ضلال
لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. They will say, the people of hellfire, to the gatekeepers of hellfire, they will say, ادعوا ربكم, call your Lord. How should I say this? Call your Lord to give us one day off. يعني
ادعوا ربكم يخفف عنا يوما من العذاب. Ask your Lord to reduce the pain only for a day. Ask your Lord to reduce the pain, the punishment, the hardship only for a day. يعني they're asking for a day off. يوما من العذاب. بس يوم. Only one day. We want one day off. What would they be told? They will be told,
haven't Prophet be sent out to you? Haven't messengers come? Yes, نعم, they did. قالوا فدعوا. You can call all you want. All your calls shall not be answered. Now the final wish. The final wish in Surah Al-Zukhruf. And this wish, my brothers and sisters, will be addressed to the master gatekeeper of hellfire. His name is Malik. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
وَنَادَوْ يَا مَالِكَ ونادوا يا مالك ونادوا يا مالك يا مالك يا مالك يا مالك يا مالك يا مالك.
Ibn Kathir says they will be calling يا مالك for 1,000 years. He will not answer to them.
يا مالك ونادوا يا مالك. Oh مالك.
His name is the gatekeeper, the master gatekeeper of everybody.
يا مالك يا مالك ليقضي علينا ربك ليقضي علينا ربك.
This is it. Once he says نعم, what's going on? He will say ليقضي علينا ربك. We wish to die. Oh مالك, let your Lord finish us off. خلاص, we want to die. ليقضي علينا ربك.
قال إنكم ماكثون.
He will tell them,
you shall remain in it forever. قال إنكم ماكثون. You shall stay in it forever and ever. والعياذ بالله.
Five wishes altogether, my dear brothers and sisters, all gone in vain. This is just a preview. And I don't want to dwell into hellfire because inshallah ta'ala, you are not going to be amongst the people of hellfire. You will be amongst the people of Jannah. So with your permission, can I talk a little bit about Jannah? Can I? Because we talked about hellfire a little bit and the wishes of the people of hellfire. Can I talk about the people of Jannah? Yes or yes? You don't have no choice. I call it Egyptian democracy. Yes or yes? طيب. The people of Jannah. The people of Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, remember, it's all Quran today. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم.
وسيق الذين اتقوا ربهم إلى الجنة زمرا. وسيق الذين اتقوا ربهم إلى الجنة زمرا. حتى إذا جاءوها وفتحت أبوابها وقال لهم خزنتها سلام عليكم.
The first thing you will hear there is سلام عليكم.
سلام عليكم.
No high. No high high. Because in Norway everything is doubled. High high. لا. There is مفيش high.
سلام عليكم.
سلام. I was on Islam channel one time and one sister called and she said, hi Sheikh. I said, wa alaykum hi. Hi, wa alaykum. طيب, in Jannah, there's no hi. The first thing, they would say,
salamun alaykum, salamun alaykum, tibtum fadkhuluha khalidin.
وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا رَبَّهُمْ. I'm going to call two people to come on stage because I want to demonstrate this. I always do this. So I need two people who want to go to Jannah. Yalla, yalla. Tfaddal, ta'al ma'a hina. I need one more. Somali, akhi. Somali, ta'al. Ta'al. You don't want to go to Jannah. You don't want to go to Jannah. La hawla. You don't want to go to Jannah. Ta'al, ta'al. Waalaikum salam. Ta'al, ya habibi, hina. Are you sorry? Afghanistan, come here. Yeah. Bosnia.
Both are from Afghanistan.
Both are from Afghanistan. It doesn't matter. Come, yes. Ta'ali, Habib, ta'ali. We will enter Jannah, inshallah, ta'ala. I just want to show the audience how we will enter it, bi-idhnillah. Ta'ali, Habib, ta'ali. Look, you're going to miss big time on this, my brother. Akhi, Somali. Ya, akhi. Look, watch. One time the Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, talking to the Sahaba, and then he took the hand of Abu Bakr and took the hand of Umar, and he said, we will enter Jannah like this.
You are in Jannah, khalas, go.
The Prophet Muhammad said, we will enter Jannah like this. وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا رَبَّهُمْ إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ زُمَرَىٰ. And the people who have believed in the Lord, they will be entering Jannah in groups because we are here in groups, alhamdulillah. We pray in jama'ah and we fast, mashallah, in groups and we break our fasting groups. And inshallah ta'ala, Jannah, we shall enter in groups. We will not going to be entering Jannah alone. Yes, my brother, your wife will be with you. You have a problem with that? You got a problem with that? She is warak, warak, my friend. You know, so, na'am, she will be there with you, bi-idhnillah. So, in groups, And then when they reached the gates of Jannah, Futihat abwabuha, wa qala lahum khazanatuha, and the khazanah, they will say, Salamun alaykum. You know what they will be, what they'll reply? They will say, Allahumma anta as-salam, wa minka as-salam, tabarakta ya dal jalali wal ikram. Oh Allah, you are the peace and the source of peace, and peace come from you. Subhanak. Allahumma anta as-salam. What will you be doing in Jannah? Oh, the brothers, I'm not talking to you. Sisters, what will you be doing in Jannah? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Waqi'ah,
يَطُوفُ عَلَيْهِمْ وِلْدَانٌ مُخَلَّدُونَ بِأَكْوَابٍ وَأَبَارِيقَ وَكَأْسٍ مِّن مَعِينٍ لا يصدعون عنها ولا ينزفون وفاكهة مما يشتهون ولحم طير وفاكهة مما يتخيرون ولحم طير مما يشتهون وحور
ايش now you're talking
وحور عين كأمثال اللؤلؤ المكنون جزاء بما كانوا يعملون لا يسمعون فيها لغوا ولا تأثيما إلا قيلا سلاما سلاما.
They have these immortal beautiful boys coming around with these drinks of wine which does not intoxicate them, and beautiful fruits with and fruits which they have never seen, and meat which they have, which their soul will desire, and these beautiful, you know, their wives which they will accompany them. حُنْعِينَ كَأَمْثَالِ اللُّؤْلُؤِ الْمَكْنُونِ جَزَاءً بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. My brothers and sisters, I only have 10 minutes left to talk about Jannah. It's not fair. It is not fair, really, to talk about Jannah in 10 minutes. But instead, what I'm going to talk about is what are the pathways to lead to Jannah, inshaAllah ta'ala. What are some of the pathways that will lead us to Jannah, inshaAllah? Who wants to go to Jannah, just so I know? Anybody interested? Jannah? طيب ما شاء الله لا قوة إلا بالله. طيب إن شاء الله تعالى. What are some of the pathways to go to Jannah? I'm going to make it very simple and easy for all of us, إن شاء الله تعالى. The very first easiest pathway to Jannah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Imran, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم.
وسارعوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم وجنة عرضها السماوات والأرض أعدت للمتقين. الذين
شيخ سراج, this is it, this is for tomorrow.
الذين ينفقون في السراء والضراء والكاظمين الغيظ والعافين عن الناس والله يحب المحسنين.
الله سبحانه وتعالى says in Surah Al-Imran, وسارعوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم, and rush, haste to Jannah. عرضها السماوات والأرض. The Jannah, which the width of it is the distance between the heavens and earth. Allah has prepared it for the muttaqeen, for the righteous. Who are these righteous?
الذين ينفقون في السراء والضراء. Those who spend صدقة, the easiest pathway to Jannah. Charity.
I'm not doing no fundraising. I'm just telling you about the easiest pathways to Jannah.
صدقة is one of the easiest, simplest pathway to Jannah. In fact, it does not cost much. والله الذي لا إله إلا هو. There is a door in Jannah.
Sisters and brothers, how many gates do we have in Jannah, just so we know? Huh? 8? And how many gates do we have in hellfire? Subhanallah. 7 in hellfire and 8 in Jannah. Have you ever thought about this? Allah wants more people to enter the Jannah than hellfire. He made each gate, as the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, the distance between a door panel of one gate to the other door panel of the other gate is the distance of 40 years. How many gates? 8 gates. And there is one gate called Sadaqah. Bab al-Sadaqah. You may say, Shaykh Tayyib, I'm broke. Is there another pathway to Jannah? Naam. There's many other pathways. Let me share with you maybe one more, inshaAllah ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, in Surah Al-Imran again.
والذين إذا فعلوا فاحشة أو ظلموا أنفسهم والذين إذا فعلوا فاحشة أو ظلموا أنفسهم ذكروا الله فاستغفروا لذنوبهم ومن يغفر الذنوب إلا الله ومن يغفر الذنوب إلا الله ولم يصروا على ما فعلوا وهم يعلمون أولئك جزاؤهم مغفرة من ربهم وجنات مش جنة واحدة وجنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها وبئس مثوى ونعم أجر فنعم أجر العاملين.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا فَعَلُوا فَاحِشَةً And those who commit sins, and then they wrong themselves, they remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then they seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah says, وَمَنْ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ اللَّهِ
وَمَنْ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ And who is the one who forgives the sins other than Allah? Sometimes you may wrong a person, and you ask that person to forgive you, and that person refuses to forgive you. That person may be a loved person, maybe a loved one, maybe somebody from your own family, which maybe you have wronged, and you ask that person to forgive you, and that person refuses to forgive you. But Allah would never refuse to forgive you, because He says, وَمَنْ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ And who is the one who forgives the sins other than Allah? وَلَمْ يُصَرُّوا عَلَى مَا فَعَلُوا وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ And they are not persistent in committing sins. What's their reward? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أُولَئِكَ جَزَاءُهُمْ مَغْفِرَةٌ مِّن رَبِّهِمْ Their jaza, their reward is forgiveness from their Lord and jannat, يعني jannat, and heavens, not only one heaven, heavens run beneath it, anhar, khalidina fiha, anhar run beneath it, rivers, they shall remain in it forever and ever. What is the key here? The key is tawbah. Those who wrong themselves, like myself, they wrong themselves, they do something wrong, they commit evil, they commit sins, but then they realize and then they repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sisters and brothers, one of the easiest pathways to Jannah is at-tawbah, is repentance. Some of us renew this repentance every year. Some of us, we wait until Ramadan. Some of us, we wait until Arafah to renew that repentance. We need to renew that repentance, because Ibn Qayyim rahmatullah alayhi says that At-Ta'ib, Habibullah, At-Ta'ib is beloved to Allah. And At-Ta'ib, يعني the one who really knows the value, the true value of Tawbah, he lives with Tawbah until the day he meets Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because the Tawbah is not only meant for the sinners. At-Tawbah is meant for all of us. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. Tubu ila Allah. Oh, you who believe, repent to Allah. Allah is not saying, oh, you sinners. Allah is saying, oh, you who believe. Afillahi shak. Afillahi shak. Fatiri samawati wal ard. يدعوكم ليغفر لكم من ذنوبكم. The beauty is that Allah is calling us for what? So that He can forgive us. أفي الله شك سورة إبراهيم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, is there any doubt in Allah? He's calling you, sisters and brothers. You know, it is not the peace conference who called you today. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called you today. For what reason? Listen to this. Na'am, there's so many Muslims. In fact, when I entered and I asked the brothers in the city, I said, what happened to the conference this year? What is going on? What happened? Why the numbers is not like last year and the year before? I asked that question. And they said, subhanallah. There's so many Muslims. Naam, there's so many people. Akhi, there's so many people who are more handsome than you. More handsome. Naam, mashallah, you are. But there are people who are more handsome than you. Allah did not select them to be here today. And there are more women. No, more women. And there are more people. La hawla shuf kif. Because the sisters may have, what do you mean? And there are more sisters who are more beautiful than you, sisters. Maybe is that not good to say? I should say, and there are more people who are healthier than you.
they are not here today. There are more people who are wealthier than you. They are not here today. There are more people who are more fortunate than you. They are not here today. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has meticulously selected you today to be here. Why? So He can forgive you. Ah, you like that? Huh? It's not me who said. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يدعوكم, He calls you. ليغفر لكم. Sisters and brothers, and we'll end with this. A story of Imam Hassan al-Basri. You may have heard of this Imam Hassan al-Basri. He was in Medina. And then he saw this funeral, this janazah, being carried by four people. Normally, janazah, you know what janazah, right? A funeral in janazah, right? In Norwegian, what do we call janazah? The grau. Megrauza. Megrauza. So there was this Megrauza being carried by four people. Hassan al-Basri, and there was this woman behind them crying. So normally janaza is carried by lots of people. So Hassan al-Basri, he follows the janaza. He says, Wallahi la kunanna khamisahuma. There were four people only. So he says, by Allah, I shall be the fifth. So he goes and he carried the janazah with them. They buried the janazah, and then he stayed back. And then he found that woman who was also going with the janazah, an old woman. She sat down crying, and she was making this dua. So he came so close to her to listen to what she was saying. And she says, Ya Rabbi, Ya Rabbi, hadha ibni fulan. ابني العاصي ذو القلب القاسي يا رب ليس لي رب سواك اللهم اغفر له وارحمه. Oh Allah, this is my son. She was saying in her dua. Oh Allah, this is my son, the sinner with the hardened heart. Oh Allah, have mercy upon my son. If your mom is here today, you should go quickly and give her a hug. And you should ask her to make dua for you. Because all I know, wallahi, that dua coming from your mother to you could be the only vehicle that would drive you to Jannah. This mother, she stayed back making dua and crying. And Hassan al-Basri is listening. And then all of a sudden, she stood up, she smiled, and she left. Hassan al-Basri went to those guys. He said, by Allah, why? Who are you? Who's the janazah? Who's this man? He said, don't ask us, as that woman, we're only hired. He said, huh? You were hired to do this? He says, we're hired. She paid us money to do this. So he went to her. Ya amat Allah. Ya amat Allah. Billah alik. She said, leave me alone. He said, by Allah, I am Hassan al-Basri. I'm the Imam of Medina. I just want to ask you a question. She says, because you're Hassan al-Basri, I will answer your question. What do you want? He says, whose janazah is this? She says, that's my son. My son has not left a sin which he did not do. He used to be a sinner. He sinned so much that I made dua for Allah. I made dua against him. But what people do not know about my son is that my son has repented to Allah. People don't know this. I made two dua for my son. The first dua for Allah to avenge him. I made dua for Allah Azza wa Jal to curse my son. Allah answered that dua and he afflicted him with a disease that put him in bed. The dua of a mother. And then I made another dua for him. And Allah answered that dua. Before he died, because he got sick, he called me, Mom, please come. Put me on the ground and put my cheek on the floor, on the ground, and put your right foot on my cheek and say, هَذَا جَزَاءُ مَنْ يَعْصِ اللَّهِ. And say, put your foot on my cheek and say, this is the reward, the consequence of those who sin. Those who sin. Oh mother, بَاللَّهِ عَلَيْكَ, when I die, don't tell people because they don't know the reality about me. Hire some people to carry me, to bury me. But before they bury me, they will need to wash me. So let them wash me first and shroud me and carry me and bury me. Oh, mother, please, I'm going to ask you one last favor. Before you leave, stay and keep making dua and don't leave until you see a sign from Allah. Don't leave until you see a sign from Allah. She says, Ya Hassan, wallahi alladhi la ilaha illahu. I was making dua, Ya Rabbi, hada ibn al-Asi, dhul qalb al-Qasi. Oh Allah, this is my son with the hardened heart, my son, the sinner. Ya Rabbi, have mercy upon him. Ya Hassan, she says, wallahi alladhi la ilaha illahu. I swear by Allah who holds my soul, I heard the voice of my son from his grave telling me, Ya Ummah, oh mother, leave. Allah has forgiven me. Allah has forgiven me. إلهي إلهي إلى من أرتجي وما غير عفوك عني أريد عبيدك قد أرصدوا بابهم وليس لي سواك إله العبيد ليس لي سواك إله العبيد. We have no way other than Allah, and we have nobody else other than Allah. But all I know, my brothers and sisters, and I swear by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if we all of us tonight, not tomorrow, tonight, now, inshallah ta'ala, if all of us, that battle, that hero, that heroine, if she was to stand and say, today is the day, inshallah, I will renew my repentance. Today is not Independence Day. Today is Repentance Day. Today, inshallah ta'ala, if all of us were to stand and renew our tawbah with Allah Azza wa Jal, wallahi ladhi la ilaha illahu, before we stand and before we leave that door, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shall not only forgive us, He shall forgive us and He shall convert all our bad deeds into good deeds. Why? Because He is Al-Ghafur, He is Al-Ghafar, He is Al-Tawwab, He is Al-Afu. He loves to forgive. We love to sin, but Allah loves to forgive. So who is the hero? Who is this brave man, brothers, who would say, I will make tawbah to Allah tonight, right now? Who? Anybody? Anybody? Sisters, who is that heroine, that brave lady, that brave sister who would say, I tonight, enough is enough. Today, khalas. No more missing salah from today on. No more missing salah. Fajr, brothers, in the masjid. Isha, in the masjid. No more dishonoring my parents from today on. Khalas. Salah on time. Quran. Dhikr of Allah Azza wa Jal. Khalas. From when? Right now, we're going to renew our repentance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No more. Today is the new you. Today is your new birthday. My daughter, she had a birthday a couple days ago and I said, I don't do this. She says, Baba, I don't call it birthday. I call it birth week. She's trying to fool me. I said, La birth week or la birthday? Yani she wants something. I said, Mefi la birthday. Sisters and brothers, today is your new birthday. All of you stand up. Stand up! La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. If this is your birthday, yani this is your new, khalas, your new, you remember today, 2018, what's October, what? September, hatta ana mdayya. September ish? September what? 20-ish? 29. Because in Canada it's 29 still, yani 29 here as well. Okay, because we pray five times a day. Do you guys pray five times a day as well? طيب, yani we're same, similar. طيب, alhamdulillah. I want you to hug the brother next to you, you hug the sister next to you, and wish them, mashallah, tabarakallah, happy Repentance Day. Happy Repentance Day. Today is your repentance. Today is the day. Today, alhamdulillah, is Allah Azza wa Jal will accept your tawbah bi-idhnillah. Khalas, alhamdulillah. Allahumma lak alhamd. Mabruk, mabruk, mabruk. Mabruk alaykum. Mubarak, mubarak, mubarak. Mubarak alaykum. Today is Eid Day. May Allah bless you. May Allah reward you. May Allah grant you all the highest level in Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you all and your loved ones and your parents, those who are alive, and your sisters and brothers and husbands and wives and children. May Allah grant you all the highest level in Jannah and make you the neighbor of Prophet Muhammad in Jannah, inshallah ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make your last word in this dunya, La ilaha illallah. May Allah make you amongst those who will drink from the hands of the Prophet Muhammad in Jannah. May Allah make you amongst those who will see the face of Allah every day in Jannah. Ameen, ameen, ameen. Zakumullah khair, barakallahu fikum, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.
Stop! 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 I have a serious warning about the Muslims in Norway. Our youth have lost touch with their deen, and this means that the majority of them don't pray Salah, even though their parents do.
But here's the scary part. Once these kids get older without praying, and they get married and have children themselves, their kids aren't even going to know about Salah. And this is going to become the reality for a large portion of the Muslims in Norway.
We are working hard to solve this problem. Alhamdulillah, we've held over 30 conferences with thousands of people attending. We've flown in scholars from around the world and tried our best to re-establish their connection with Allah. But unfortunately, these conferences are not enough to make changes in the masses of our youth.
What we really need is a permanent Norwegian Muslim youth center, a masjid where the youth can transform their lives and become true worshippers of Allah. And we already have half the amount, but we need your help to reach the remaining 50%.
You can inshallah share in the reward of all those youth learning how to praise Allah. And when they grow up and have children who also start praying, you will share in their reward too.
The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the two rak'as before Fajr are better than this world and what's inside it. And subhanallah, one person praying two rak'as before Fajr is better than the entire world and everything it contains. Can you then imagine getting the reward of hundreds of people praying Fajr every single day? All of this because of the Islamic center that you helped establish.
So please, for the sake of Allah, help us establish this masjid and get your continuous reward and a palace in Jannah, inshallah. Click the button and donate now. And please, don't forget to share this video to get extra reward. Jazakallahu khairan.